known by his own fruit. For a thorn men do not gather, figs, nor a bramble bush gather they grapes. A good man out of the good treasure of his heart bringeth forth that which is good, and an evil man out of the evil treasure of his heart bringeth forth that which is evil. For of the abundance of the heart his mouth speaketh. Amen?
Amen.
You know, it's not hard to recognize a Christian these days because the world has waxed worse and worse. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
And we're starting to see a lot of the world in the church today. Amen? We're starting to see a lot of, if you would, backbiting, gossiping, and things that are not of God being done in the house of God today. Amen? And that's sad because what we've done is we've not watched what we've allowed to take place in our own life. Amen? Let me tell you tonight, amen, that we're all known by the fruit that which we bear. Amen? And if our fruit is rotten, then it's not good. Amen? Wow. The Bible tells us to neither mix sweet water. How does it say that, Brother Johnny? Can you help me out? And bitter water, thank you. Bitter and sweet water together, amen? I'm sorry to put you on the spot. I just lost my thought there. Well, I'm glad LaVon was listening, amen, and had it, amen? You know, it's very important that we don't allow ourselves to filter in to the things of the world, amen? When we've been born again, we have to learn to keep filtered out of the world, amen?
Come on.
We have to learn to do the things that which God would have us to do. Amen. And the Lord laid on my heart tonight, amen, as I was standing up here singing, amen, all of a sudden I began to picture a garden. Amen. Didn't know I was going to say this until while we were singing. Amen. And God started laying this on my heart. And I began to picture a garden and how that you have to work in the garden, amen, so that you can produce the vegetables and the things that are good to eat, amen. If you don't work that garden, then you'll end up with a bunch of weeds and you won't have a good garden, amen. And if you don't work it and water it, fertilize it, and do the things that which you need to do to produce a good garden, amen, then you won't have much of a garden, amen.
Yes.
Same way in our Christian walk with God. If we don't begin to filter out the things of the world, amen, and begin to cling to that which is good, which is God, amen, and the things of God, then we'll find ourselves eventually drifting away from God instead of drawing closer to Him. The Bible says, he that hunger and thirst after righteousness shall be filled, amen. I don't know about you, but I need all of God that I can get, especially in these last days, amen. I can tell you, amen, I've grown a hunger for God this last year that greater than that which I've had in a long time. And it's because of the things that I've seen God doing in my life and because of the time that I've spent with Him.
Come on.
This last year in prayer and listening to Him, amen, hearing His voice and drawing close to Him and allowing Him to talk to me. I like it when I wake up in the middle of the night and God is speaking something to me. I like it even better when my wife's waking me up saying, you know, you've been speaking in tongues and there I am asleep. Amen. That lets me know that God is working on me. Amen. And I can tell you God will always take care of His children. But we have to learn to become a children of obedience, a children that's willing to allow His Word to work in our life and to filter out the things of the world, amen, to cling to Him, amen, in times of trouble, to look unto Him, and in times of good times, lift Him up and magnify Him and acknowledge why you are having a good time, amen. Exalt Him above everyone and everything in your life, amen. Give Him praise and glory and honor because He deserves it, amen. Let me tell you, there's ways that we can work the garden, amen. There's ways that we can build our spirit man back up, amen. And we have to do this day by day. The Bible says it's a daily walk with the Lord. Amen. It's one day at a time. Amen. It's not the last 10 years, but it's one day at a time. Yes, it's good to look back on past experiences. Amen. David had to encourage himself at times in his walk with the Lord. And there's times that we have to do this, especially in times of trouble. Amen. Especially in times of storms and trials and tribulations, we have to keep the faith, amen. And we can't give in to the things of the enemy, amen, or the things of the world and let the world come in and sow doubt in us, amen. But we've got to keep those things worked out of the garden, amen. I'm telling you, there's weeds and tares, amen, that we need to keep out of the garden, amen, so that we can produce the fruit that God would have us to produce, amen. If you don't know what I'm talking about a spiritual garden. I'm talking about a walk with God, the walk that God would have you to walk with Him, amen. We can't be like the world and please God.
Come on.
We got to come out from amongst the world. Yes, it's important that we be careful at what we allow to come in our homes, amen. Very important that we be careful at what we allow our kids to watch on TV, amen. And it's even more important that we be careful who they hang out with, amen, and run around with because they're associated with those at which they hang out with. I can tell you, amen, it wouldn't be good to run around with somebody that steals and lies and cheats, amen, because you know what? Eventually you'll fall into that same category with them. Amen. Or else, let me tell you something. If you want to end up in jail, run around with those that's headed to the jailhouse. Amen.
Come on.
But you know, if you want to be who God's called you to be, then you need to hang out with those that's striving to be like Christ. Amen. Need to be connected to the vine. Amen. The power source that comes from Jesus. Amen. It's not in what we can do, but it's what He can do in us. Amen? And God can do a magnificent work in your life if you only humble yourself and learn to sit at His feet. Amen? Take time to get along with Him. Work the garden, amen, if you would. Till it, amen. Water it, fertilize it, amen. How do you do that? Through the Word of God, amen. The Word of God will purify you, amen. The Bible says He'll clean you up, amen. You're having troubles with something, the best thing to do is take it to God. Amen. Take it to the Word. Amen. And let the Word begin to work you. Amen. And filter those things out of your life. Amen. See, there's something, I've always said this, there's something about getting in the shower. Amen. And turning on the water. Amen. That cleans you up. But the water don't just clean you. Amen. It washes and rinses you. It's the soap and the rag and the shampoo and the things that all the ingredients inside that shower that you use, amen, that clean you up. And that's what the Word of God does in our life, amen. We have to become the fruit bearers that God would have us to be, amen.
Come on.
The Bible says that a good tree bringeth forth good fruit, right? And an evil tree bringeth forth evil fruit.
That's what it says.
If you're running with somebody, amen, hanging out with somebody or talking to someone that does things that God's not pleased with, then you know your job is to pray for them, not to hang out with them. Okay? God don't want you hanging out with the world. God wants you to hang out with His children. Amen? You know, too much spirit and not enough water is about like eating a box of crackers and not having nothing to drink. you'll choke to death, right? You got to have a balance, y'all. You got to learn to spend time with God. You got to learn to read His Word. You got to learn to come to church, amen, and lift Him up and magnify Him, worship Him, amen. These things in our life God would have us to do, a lot of times we neglect doing them, amen. Praise the Lord. But I can tell you tonight, amen, God don't want us to neglect to doing the things that He would have us to do. Amen. He wants us to work these last days. He wants us to put forth the effort to seek after Him and search for Him and to keep that hunger and thirst. Amen. To eat of the bread of life. Amen. Which is the Word. Amen. Not only eat it on Sundays and Wednesdays, but every day of the week. It's a day-to-day walk with Him.
Come on.
You know, I can tell you tonight, amen, that some of you are listening and some of you are not here with me tonight. Amen. But I can tell you, if you'll get into this Word tonight, amen, and begin to listen with a spiritual ear, you'll hear what God's saying to you tonight. Amen. He'll show you the things that He would have you to change. Amen. He'll lead you and guide you in a path of righteousness and holiness. And it's your choice now tonight whether you make the right choice or the wrong choice. God's not going to make you. But if there's things in your life you know that you need God to help you with, whether it be an attitude or an addiction, amen.
Come on.
Whether it be the way that you talk or the way that you walk. No matter what it might be, God wants to change those things in your life that don't please Him. Amen. How many of you want to be blessed? We sang that song, I'm blessed. If you want to be blessed, then you got to learn to walk with God. You've got to learn to talk with God. Amen. You've got to get along with Him and spend time with Him. Most of all, you've got to learn to obey Him. Amen. Obedience. Something God is very pleased with in your life. And He blesses you when you walk in obedience. Amen. The Bible says that God blesses those that walk in obedience. Amen. Turn with me to Matthew chapter 13. Amen. There are several places in here where it talks about the sower. Amen.
Amen.
And I want to, it's different parables here. Amen. In chapter 13, I want to start right here with verse 18. Amen. It says, "Hear ye therefore the parable of the sower. When any one heareth the word of the kingdom and understandeth it not, then cometh the wicked one and catcheth away that which was sown in his heart. This is he which received seed by the wayside." Amen. I want to share another one of those in a minute about the wayside. "But he that receiveth the seed into a stony place, the same is he that heareth the word, and annoyed with joy receiveth thee. Yet hath he not root in himself, but dureth for a while, for when tribulation or persecution arises because of the word, by and by he is offended." Amen.
Come on.
That's he that's on stony ground. Amen. "He also that receiveth seed among the thorns is he that heareth the word, and the care of this world and the deceitfulness of riches choke the word, and he becometh unfruitful." You know, God don't want us to be unfruitful. He don't want the word not to have rain in our life, I guess the best way of saying it. Amen. God wants His Word to produce that which He sent it forth to do. Amen. He wants His Word to have effect in our life. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
He wants us God loves us so much, when we do something wrong, Sister Sue, He sends conviction unto us. Amen? He don't condemn us, but He convicts us and lets us know that what we've done is wrong. Now He gives us an opportunity to do what's right. What do you mean, Brother Derek? Well, He gives us an opportunity to repent and to cry out for His help. Mm-hmm. But when we fail to do that, you know what we fail to do? We fail to live for God.
Yep.
We fail to serve Him. We more or less are turning our back on Him and saying, God, this is what I'd rather do than to please You. We're all guilty at times, because a lot of times, Brother Johnny, there's too much of us and not enough of Him.
That's the truth.
That's the truth of the matter. We have to learn to die so that He can live. Praise the Lord. That's the second time that thing went off bugging me, amen, so I get rid of it, amen. You know, it's kind of like the world will always try to filter into your life if you let it. But how to keep the world out is to keep God's Word close to your heart, amen. To keep the ground fertile to where God can do a good work is through a prayer life, spending time with Him, getting along with Him, reading God's Word, and doing the things that which God would have you to do. And you know what's going to happen? When you do that, you're going to grow up. You're going to become the Christian God's called you to be. But when you neglect to do those things, like coming to church when the doors are open.
Yes.
When you neglect to do that which God would have you to do, what you're doing is you're more or less letting the weeds and the tares come in. See, when we give the devil an inch, he takes us for a mile. You know, when I hear, I've chosen in my life, let's just use this as an example, amen. I've chosen in my life not to listen to nothing but Christian music. There's a reason for that. Now, there's some Christian music I'd rather not listen to, because it's not appealing to me. Amen? Although it may appeal to Brother Cletus, or it may appeal to Kamar. Different age groups, different music. Amen? But as long as it's compelling Jesus, I don't mind it. Amen? Don't mean I like it, but I'll listen to it.
Come on.
But when it comes to listening to rock or country music or jazz or bluegrass or anything else, I'd rather not hear it at all. You know why? Because I want to produce good fruit. Amen? So, well, Brother Derek, I don't see nothing wrong. Well, that's between you and God. My convictions, I'm not listening to it. See, I know who's kept me all these years. I know the reason I'm still standing where I'm at is because of Him, not because of me. Amen. Mm-hmm. I don't want to let the world in. Amen. I want to keep the world out. Amen. That don't mean I don't care for those that are in the world, because there's a lot of people that I know that are lost that I care for. Amen. I want to see them saved and born again, Brother Johnny. Amen. But if I live like the world, how can I expect them to get saved? Amen. See, we've got to produce the right fruit. Amen? And there's conditions in order to produce the right fruit. You've got to work the ground, amen, and keep the things out so that God can produce the fruit that He wants to produce in your life. Amen? I can tell you today, amen, that a lot of people aren't watching out for what they're allowing in their garden. Amen? A lot of Christians today are letting everything, just any old thing, come down the pike. Amen? They're living however they want to, doing whatever they want to, when they want to, and it don't matter what God says. Let me tell you, God's not pleased with that kind of Christian. Amen?
Come on.
And I can tell you that my Bible tells me that sin shall not enter into the kingdom of heaven. Now, I know good and well as you're sitting here and I'm up here, amen, that every one of us sin and fall short of the glory of God. We all do. There's not a one in here that don't sin, amen.
Right.
But we're to try to not sin, amen? We're to strive to do what's right. We're to serve God with all our heart. We're to read and pray and spend time with Him and get along with Him. And we're truly supposed to repent when we do something wrong.
Yeah, we are.
Amen?
That's right.
Paul said that he repent daily. Amen? It would do some of you some good to repent. Amen? Maybe then you could start growing again. You feel like that you hadn't grown in a while. You feel like you're the same as you was 10 years ago and that nothing changed. You don't know sometimes why you even come to church. Don't get nothing out of it. You know why? Because you won't repent. You won't work the ground. You won't get along with God and spend time with God. Now, I'm just telling you the truth. See?
Come on, brother.
This is what the Word tells us. Amen. If the Word come forth, amen, and we're not willing to receive the Word, receive correction. Correction comes from the Lord. We're not willing to receive correction and turn from the wicked one unto the right one, amen. Then you know what's wrong? There's something wrong in our garden, amen. I promise you, there's weeds growing up and it's choking out that which God would have to grow, amen. God wants us all to produce good fruit. Amen. The right fruit, not evil fruit. Amen.
Mom.
He wants us to grow and mature into the Christian that He's called us to be. If we want to be a witness in unto a lost and dying world, we've got to become who God wants us to be. Amen. And the only way you're going to do that is if you'll die. Though a grain of wheat fall into the ground and die, it abideth alone. Amen. If there's too much of you, you know what you have to do? You have to crucify your flesh. And It starts by running to an old-fashioned altar and crying out to God and saying, God, I need you. God, I didn't realize, but I realize tonight, God, that there's things that I'm doing that you're not pleased with. And I know, God, that you would have me to repent of these, God. And I just ask you right now to forgive me, God, and to help me not do this no more.
Come on.
Amen. And if you do that and you mean it with all your heart, the Bible says that he that run unto God with a broken heart and a contrite spirit, that God in no wise will turn away. Amen.
Well, it says.
God's no respecter of a person. He loves you just like He loves me. Amen. He loves a sinner just as much as He loves the Christian. He just won't bless the sinner like He will a Christian. Oh, yes, God blesses the just and the unjust. He does. There's people out there in this world that don't know God, amen, and they're blessed, but they're not going to take those things with them to heaven, amen. They're not blessed like you are. As a child of the King, you've already inherited it all, amen. You're just looking at it through the wrong eyes if you're troubled and bothered with them and what they've got. And let me tell you, what you're dealing with is a jealous spirit, amen.
Amen.
And covetousness, and you need to get rid of that. See, that's rotten fruit, amen. You've got to recognize those things and realize that God wants to purge you from those things of the world. Amen. He wants to cleanse and wash you. Amen. So that you can become the fruit that He's called you to be. We read where there's on the briar bush that there's not no grapes there. Amen. But there's thorns on the briar bush.
Amen.
Amen. And on the fig, there's grapes, right? On the vine. See, grapes aren't going to grow on the brow bushes, I think is what it said.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yep, thistles.
Because brow bushes don't produce grapes. Do you understand? If you're going to be a Christian, you've got to surrender to God. You've got to give up your life and take a hold of the cross and begin to follow after Him with all your heart, mind, soul, and body. Know you're not perfect, but you're striving. Amen. And that's all God asked us to do, Sister Sue, is to strive to be like Christ.
Amen.
And if we do that, you know what? Yes, there's still some changes that God's going to make in your life. There's things that you're going to have to learn to give up. There's changes going to be made in your life until you make it to heaven.
That's right.
I promise you. But you know what? There's a promise that he makes to all those that strive to be like him, that they can make heaven their home. Amen? And I believe God's the one that bears good fruit. Amen? I believe it's God's the one that wants us to do the things that he would have us to do, and he'll reward us through our obedience. It says, but he that receiveth seed into the good ground is he that heareth the word and understandeth it, and which also beareth fruit and bringeth forth some 100-fold, some 60, and some 30. What are you doing with what you've received from God? Amen? What are you doing? The Bible speaks of talents. Somewhere else in the Bible, I didn't look this up, amen. Just going to paraphrase it real quickly, but God gave one talent. He gave one, two, I believe, and one, five, amen. And the one that received one talent, he buried it. He didn't do nothing with it.
Buried it.
The other two, they took theirs and used it, amen.
Invested it.
Sold it, if you would. What good is a seed if you're not going to do nothing with it?
Not going to plant it, that's right.
It ain't going to produce anything, is it?
That's right.
You first got to take the seed and you got to place it in good ground.
Yeah.
Right? Amen? You got to put it in a place that it can produce. Amen?
Yes, you do.
You can't hide it. The Bible says what good is it to hide. Place a candle under the bushel or something like that, under the bed. What good is it going to do? It's not going to do anything. See, God wants to be seen in our lives. But we first have to be connected with him, Brother Johnny. We have to yield ourselves and humble ourselves unto him into a place that God can take us and use us. Amen? And help us to grow. Amen? I want to say this tonight, and I believe that you can hear what God's trying to tell you, amen. If you're going to produce anything, you first have to lay your life down.
Yes, amen. You do.
And when you do this, amen, God will take you. He'll begin to use you. He'll water you. He'll feed you and clothe you and bathe you. And he'll make you into the Christian that he's called you to be. Amen. You'll begin to bear fruit. Amen. Let's just put it that way. Amen.
Amen.
You'll begin, the change will begin to be made in your life. I can remember, Brother Johnny, when I got born again. I walked into the church, a crack cocaine addict. I walked out of the church, a born again Christian. You know what the difference was? I no longer wanted to do the things that which I was doing. Amen? I accepted the change. Amen? I didn't want to do the things that I wanted to do before I went in. When I went in, I was addicted. When I came out, I'd been transformed into the creature that God had called me to be. I was a new creature. No longer did I want to do the crack and smoke dope and run around and party and hang out with the thugs. Amen? But I wanted to read my Bible.
Come on, bro.
I wanted to get to know Jesus. See, I knew there was a difference in my life. God made the difference. I didn't do anything but fall down in an old-fashioned altar and mean it with all my heart. Didn't want to live like that no more. I was tired of living that way. See, I had a lot of growing to do, still got a lot of growing to do. I found out this past week that I still wasn't who I needed to be. Amen? What do you mean, Brother Derek? No, I'm not back on drugs. Thank God. No, I'm not wanting to do the things I used to do. But I found some rotten fruit. Amen? You know what I had to do? I had to crucify. Had to cry out to God and ask God to help me to humble me and help me to do the right thing, God. God, you show me what you would have me to do, God. God, and I promise you I'll do it, but God, I don't know what to do in this situation. So, God, I'm asking you right now to lead me and guide me in a path of righteousness. You know what, George? Getting along with God, spending time with Him, Sister Sandra.
Yeah, come on.
He told me exactly what I needed to do.
Come on, brother.
Now, I still had a choice.
Yeah, you could do it or not.
Now, did I want to serve God or serve my flesh? You know what? I chose to serve God. I'm glad. See, I can tell on myself. You can't get mad at me. I mean, you can, but it won't do you no good because I'm going to forgive you anyways. Amen? But I can tell you this, amen, because I experienced it. Amen?
Amen.
God's a good God, Sister LaVon. He's a forgiving God, and He's a loving God, and He wants us to do that which is right. He wants us to work the ground, amen, to fertilize it, to water it, amen, so that we can grow, amen.
Come on.
So we can produce the right fruit, amen.
Yes.
The good fruit, amen, that only comes from above, Mark, amen. We're not always going to make the right choice.
That's right.
But when we make the wrong choice, we need to learn how to make the right choice. And the way to do that is by humbling yourself, falling at the feet of Jesus, and asking Him for His help. Amen? Don't continue to wallow around in it.
Come on.
I've always said that if He slings mud on you, don't sling mud on Him. Right? But a lot of Christians today you see slinging mud on each other. You see a lot of them are laughing and cutting up, but as soon as one of them says something that the other one don't like, next thing you know, they don't want to have nothing to do with each other.
Yeah.
Right? You know why? Because that's the evil one that's done slipped in. That's one of them weeds that needed to be plucked out of the garden. Amen? You understand? What it does is it chokes the very life of God out of that Christian. Amen? And it chokes those around them too. Amen? You know, you run with dogs, you get fleas, right? Right? That's the old saying?
Yeah.
Run with dogs, you get fleas. It's just like the old devil's always said, sticks and stones may break my bones, but words shall never hurt me. That's a lie. Words do hurt. We have to learn to let God tame our tongue. Amen? We have to. How do you do that, Brother Derek? By staying at the feet of Jesus. By spending time in His Word. By praying and meditating upon God. Amen? I can tell you, none of us can tame our tongue. The Bible says no man can tame his tongue. But God can.
Mm-hmm.
And God will let us know when we've not spent enough time with Him.
Yes, He will.
And when you recognize that you've not spent enough time with Him, you know what you need to do? Repent and ask God to forgive you and begin to spend that time with Him. Don't neglect to get along with God.
Mm-hmm.
See, God's given us a great gift, and that's one-on-one line of communication with Him through the Spirit of God. Jesus said, before I leave this walks of earth, I'm going to leave a comforter unto you. Now, we can mind the things of God and the Spirit of God and do the things God wants us to. We got a choice, or we don't have to. And let me tell you, when you choose not to, you open the door to the enemy. And he'll come in and tear down what God's trying to build.
Yes, he will.
I'm so glad that I know God will not let the enemy overcome me. Amen. Mm-hmm. I'm so glad that the Bible said no weapon formed against us shall prosper. Amen. I'm glad that God's Word says If God be for you, who can be against?
Who? Amen. That's right.
I'm glad, Brother Johnny, that God filters through the garden, amen, and gets the weeds and the tares out. Let's go on, and I want to just skip over here, amen. There was something else here I wanted to read, amen.
Bless him, Lord.
It's on down in verse 24. It goes on to say another parable. The kingdom of heaven is likened unto a man which sowed good seed in his field. But while men slept, his enemy came and sowed tares among the wheat. You know what? We need to wake up. Do you hear me?
Come on.
The children of God need to wake up. So what are you talking about, Brother Derek? Let's go on and read this. But while men slept, his enemy came and sowed tares among the wheat, and went his way. But when the blade was sprung up and brought forth fruit, then appeared the tares also. You know, it's sad when Christians blend in with the tares. Right? If we can blend in with the world, then we're not much of a Christian. That's why when I hear somebody telling a dirty joke or just an unclean joke, ain't got to have foul language in it, just something that shouldn't be said to start with. You know what I do? I walk away from it. I don't sit there and listen to it. I don't want that garbage in my ears. I get as far away from it as I can. Why? Because I don't want to let the tares in. Amen? I want to grow up and be who the fruit that God's called me to be. Amen? Be the Christian that God wants me to be. And you have to make a stand like that in your workplaces and everyday walk, in your homes and families. Amen? I got a family that half of them love the Lord and half of them don't even know the Lord. Amen? And when we get together, amen, you'll sit there and you'll watch them. Some of them will say things that just shouldn't be said. And I sit there and watch some of them that call themselves Christians sitting there laughing and cutting up with them. Something wrong with that. I don't care if they are family. It's still wrong.
That's right, brother.
You follow me? If you're not going to be a light and a beacon for Jesus Christ, then you know what? You ought not be in church. That's the way I feel about it. But I don't want those that don't know the Lord not to come to church. So I'm not going to put them down and ridicule them and act like the world. I'm going to lift them up, pray for them, and invite them to church. Amen. Teach them the things of the Lord. Amen. Let them see God in my life and in your life so they want Him to become their Lord and Savior. Amen. So we can't fall into the trap of the enemy. Amen. And fellowship with darkness like the world does. Amen? We've got to be a Christian. Amen? Somebody help me tonight. Amen? Seems like nobody wants to hear this. You say, well, Brother Derek, I'll go however I want to. And don't you worry about it. I'm not worried about it. I'm just going to pray for you. Amen? But I'm going to give you the word because it's important, amen, that we grow up and be the fruit bearers that God's called us to be. If we want to see the church grow, then we've got to do what it takes for it to grow. Amen? How can you build a church if you're going to walk around putting it down? Right? I'm just telling you the truth.
Come on, brother.
I've watched people come in and they act like they're all for us.
Oh, come on.
Go right outside these doors and hear about how bad they put us down.
Come on.
And I'm like, man, why don't they just stay out of here if they're going to come in and then sow bad seed?
Yeah.
Right?
Come on, man.
I ain't going to help the garden grow.
Yeah.
You know what it does? We can't communicate with one another by encouraging one another. We don't need to communicate at all.
Amen.
It's best to keep our mouth shut. If you ain't got nothing good to say about me, just don't say nothing about me. Just pray for me. Amen.
Amen.
I can tell you tonight, amen, it's not about anybody in here. It's about Him.
Right.
Amen.
Exactly right.
God wants to manifest. manifest himself in your life. Judy said she's been praying for Brandy for over a year. Praise God, there she is. Prayer changes things. We don't change things. God does. Amen. And we got to let God have the glory and the honor for all things. Amen. We need to learn to lift Him up and magnify Him and thank Him for what He's doing. Amen. And that's what Judy did. She stood back there and she said, hey, look, I want to just tell you what God's done. Right? You and I, we have to be that way. In all things, Sister LaVonne, we've got to give God the glory and the honor. We've got to know that God's got our back. Amen? I've been saying that for the last 2 weeks. God's got our back. God's got this. Amen?
Yeah.
You know why? Because truly He's the only one that can get it. Amen? The Bible tells us that we can do nothing without Him. I'm trying to close this thing, but God's running with something about the tares. Amen? We can't be like the tares and call ourselves Christians. Amen? See, there's one thing. The wheat can't be a tare. All it can be is a wheat. Amen? And I can tell you, God's coming after the wheat. Amen?
Yes,
see, the tares will be burned up.
What it says.
They'll be bundled up and cast into the fire. They're not going to make heaven their home. But he that which beareth the good fruit. Amen. Come on, Brother George. Praise the Lord. No, you're good. I'm glad you was coming. Amen. You did good, brother. You heard from God. Amen. I'm glad to know you tuned in, Brother George. Amen. That makes me feel better, amen. Been back there running that sound equipment. Getting up here on the stage and knowing that you're on tune, amen. Praise the Lord. You know, we all need to get tuned in. We all need to work that garden, amen. How do I do that, Brother Derek? By praying and spending time with God. Getting along with Him. Meditating upon His Word. The Bible says take His Word and place it on the tables of your heart. Meditate on it day and night. You know, I didn't even know I was going to say anything about a garden tonight. I've been praying all afternoon, God, you got to give me something to go with this about the fruit. He waited till I got on stage to give me something else. I don't know about you, but I want to be all that God's called me to be. Amen. I'm nothing without Him. So I'm ready to get suited up. Place God's arm around me and be the Christian God's called me to be. Amen. The battle's on. Amen. Let me tell you, we fight a real devil. The Bible says he's running to and fro throughout this earth, seeking whom he may devour. You better bet that God's going to come and the devil's going to come and try to visit you, amen. He's going to come and try to find a way into your home, amen. Try to find a way in your walk, amen. Try to mess you up. But if you'll stay tuned in, amen, God's voice will always lead you and guide you. His Spirit says that He leads us and guides us in paths of righteousness and holiness for His name's sake. God will not let you down. Amen. We let Him down, but we don't need to. And we don't have to if we'll stay close to Him, Sister LaVonne. I remember a time where LaVonne was having some problems, and I hope she don't mind me sharing this. But I remember her. She'd call us up about every night, wouldn't she, Sandra? And she'd tell us how troubled she was and how bothered she was and how she didn't know what she was going to do. And she said she was having problems just getting along with God and reading His Word. She said that there was a noise that was just irritating her. Remember? Driving her insane, so to speak. Amen? She really pulled her hair out. She didn't know what she was going to do. Didn't really know what to do. She'd praying. She was asking God to help her. Doing all she knew to do. I remember a time in my walk when I experienced a tormenting spirit that had a hold on me. And I couldn't overcome it, didn't know what to do. Amen. Done everything I knew to do, Mark. Prayed, fasted. I was doing everything that I knew to do, Sister LaVon, but it was still there. See, the devil don't care. He comes to kill, steal, and destroy. But you know what? LaVon was a trooper. She didn't give up. She kept fighting, Sister Shirley. And that's what we have to do, amen? We have to keep working that garden, amen? We have to keep plowing and tilling and watering so that God can produce the fruit in our life. God said that He made us more than a conqueror through the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, that no weapon formed against us shall prosper. Amen? Death, hell, and the grave have no power over you. Satan only has the power you give him. Why don't we quit giving him place? Start giving God all the attention. Amen? That lady that crawled off in that war room, she didn't really understand what the war room was all about at first. But boy, when she got a hold of the horns of God, she got in that prayer room and she realized that that was the greatest thing she had ever experienced in her life. And I'm telling you, when you get along with God, and God begins to talk to you, you'll have it too. Amen. You'll know what's going on. Amen. And you'll know where to go when trouble comes. Amen. Let's just begin to pray more. Amen. Put our trust and faith in Him. Cleanse the house tonight, amen. If there's something in your life that you've been struggling with, bring it to God. Don't take it home with you. Ask God to pull the weeds, amen. Tell Him you want to bear good fruit, amen. How do I do that, Brother Derek? By bringing it to God. Laying it at His feet and asking Him to help you. I can tell you, last night, I couldn't sleep a wink. Seemed like I didn't get no sleep at all. I kept waking up. Fiercely, I was bothered. Didn't have anything to do with Billy or Connie or any of their family. It was teetotally something different. Now tomorrow, I've got another battle. I got to go.